Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Beat the Algorithm Challenge. So you've already watched our introductory video. I know you had a chance to watch training number one, which was all about really understanding why we want to beat the algorithm, how we can start to do that through sussing out what our top performing content was, and really what our choice of long form content, i.e. that algorithm proof content is. So hopefully you've gotten those two things done. And, you know, as we discussed yesterday, nobody has to pay attention to your content. So we really want to make sure we are giving them a reason to devote their attention towards you and your brand. And today's tip is actually going to share a really, really simple method that you can layer on top of your marketing strategy that's going to amplify the messages that you're already delivering, okay? So the first thing I want to share is the title of this training. It is called the Almanac of Relevance, okay? So the whole theme throughout this mini training here is that in order for our messages to be heard, they need to be relevant to the current times. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to share a screen with a whiteboard here and just start to give you some examples so that you can understand what the Almanac of Relevance is. So let me just write down the Almanac of Relevance. And for the purpose of this training, let's assume that you are a nutritionist, okay? So we'll do an example here for somebody who is a nutritionist. So what I want you to do is actually brainstorm what is going on in the world, pop culture, current events in the coming, let's say, 30 days, okay? So you're basically starting where you are now, looking, today's date for me is May 18th. So what I'm going to do is start brainstorming what's going on in the world as it relates to today and what's happening in the next 30 days. I'm going to draw all these spokes here and let me just start spitballing some ideas. So number one, we're coming towards the start of the summer. So I'm going to write that down because seasonal changes always give us an opportunity to play up our marketing campaigns and to add that into how we position our products. Number two, if you're a nutritionist, maybe you walked outside yesterday and you realized that rhubarb is growing in. So rhubarb recipes would be the perfect recipe to create and share right now. But you need to know these things and to actually document them in order to make sure that your content is positioned against it. Over here, we have the start of beach season. So people are going to be going to the beach a lot. Maybe, you know, you're a nutritionist that helps people with body image. So you know that there's many body image issues when we start tank tops. So that just may be something that you address with your target clientele. Maybe confidence low due to winter slumps, right? Maybe, you know, you look at pop culture right now and there's a new season of The Bachelor starting. It's a show that millions and millions of people watch. I don't know what it is, but just think about all of these different opportunities and there's no wrong brainstorm here. So just say anything and everything that comes to mind when it comes to what's happening in the coming 30 days. A lot of these are transferable to any industry, right? If you're a photographer, for example, you're also thinking about the start of summer. You're also thinking about, you know, maybe wedding season coming up. Maybe there is, you know, type of wedding that you shoot and you're giving ideas for how to maximize your day as a beach wedding. And so first we start with this brainstorm. The second thing that we're going to do is to think about what we did in yesterday's training and now position it against what we have here in our 30-day brainstorm. So let's stick on this example of being a photographer. Okay, so in yesterday's training, you would have thought about the long form content that you want to be creating as a photographer. So maybe you decided to do a weekly blog post for your community, okay? So that's your long form algorithm proof content. Then you also participated in yesterday's training where you realized what your top performing content is. And you saw that your cake smash photos, where a one-year-old smashes a cake and then smears it all over the face, maybe those are your top performing posts. And then in your brainstorm that we just did about what's relevant right now, you wrote down outdoor birthday parties. And because at the time of this recording, we're in COVID and in a lockdown, at least where I live, parents will not be able to host their whole family and friend set at their house for their kid's first birthday party. So again, let's reiterate that. You've decided on long form content of blog posts. Number two, you have decided or you've realized that cake smash photos are your top performing photos. And with the Almanac of Relevance, you've realized that, okay, what's relevant is that everyone's first birthday is going to be happening with just their, you know, parents, maybe their siblings, and who knows if anyone else will be allowed to be there. So now we want to assemble the idea, like bring in these different components to create some sort of campaign. So what I'm identifying here is an opportunity for this photographer to create something really special or to tweak one of their current packages or just to use an existing photography package and now position it against parents who are sad that their friends and family won't be at their kid's first birthday party to see the cake smash. Why not you as a photographer create a relevant message that says, I've got a solution to this problem, okay? So I want you to create a series of posts that, number one, share that you understand the challenge that these parents are going through. To be relevant, we need to enter the conversation in your dream client's mind. The conversation in their mind is, I wish that everyone could be part of, you know, little Amelia's first birthday party. So that's the first step, right? The second thing in your series of posts is you're going to want to paint a picture of what is possible instead, right? So maybe you can do a live stream. You show up at their place, you're the third guest, you do a live stream so all their family and friends can join via Zoom. And maybe then you do the photography and you create a photo book that can be shared digitally with friends and family all around the world within 24 hours of the kid's birthday. Okay, so you're showing what's possible, like you're addressing the problem in your dream client's mind. And then maybe in a third post, you share some calls to action, how to book, how many spaces do you have for these? What dates are you available? What's the price? How do people learn more about your product or service? Okay, so see how we've taken something that's going on in the world, something totally relevant that probably is your dream client's concerns, right? Because you've identified that most people are engaging with cake smash stuff, probably because they're parents. Now we take that and we position it against the thought and the conversations in our prospective clients' minds. And then we position the product and say, here's what we have to offer as a solution. So as you've probably already realized, part of our job as marketers is to keep up with what's going on in the world so that we can position our services, our solutions against what's currently happening. That's one of the easiest ways to capture somebody's attention. So if you're not using the Almanac of Relevance, then you might be missing out, okay? And you know, just to give you one more example of this. So I worked with a client who was a residential organizer. She organizes your closets, your back rooms, everything. And she was talking to me about coming up with a new marketing campaign. And all of a sudden she spun off on this story and she's like, oh, it would be cool if I had Kim Kardashian as my spokesperson. And she was talking about how she watched Keeping Up with the Kardashians. And on that previous episode, Kim Kardashian had a really messy closet. And she's like, oh, like I could totally have organized that for her. And I was like, aha, that is it. Because how many people watch that show, that reality show, Keeping Up with the Kardashians? Millions, right? They have millions of viewerships. Well, what we could do and what she did do is basically do a series of posts reorganizing Kim's closet and giving suggestions for how Kim could improve the organization and the efficiency of her huge walk-in closet. Because that was so relevant, anyone who watched that show who also was interested in organizing was completely enthused in that content. And a lot of people ended up reaching out saying, hey, do you have any tips for me? Or hey, how can I hire you? Do you have any eBooks I can buy? So again, something relevant, with the current challenge in your prospective client's mind. So I do have an entire blog post on the Almanac of Relevance. So if you go to kelseyreidel.com, you can just search in the little search query for Almanac of Relevance. The other thing is we're going to be studying this in depth inside of the Marketing Mastery Intensive, which starts on May 31st, Monday, May 31st. So you can go ahead and check that out there. It's small group coaching for those of you who want to create a marketing strategy that's going to help you find more clients, simplify your marketing efforts, and ultimately generate more revenue. Because with marketing, we get more leads in the funnel and eventually you work with more people. So more cash in your pocket. So you can visit visionarymarketingcourse.com, and that's where you can find all of the info on how to join and what we're going to be doing inside. So that's it for today's training, and I will see you for the next one.